today, what we're going to be doing is looking at thermal energy and how it affects molecules. And you're going to show me your understanding, since we work with it a little bit already, by discussing it with a partner and making some predictions. Now, I do want to show you, other than what's on the paper, what it is that you're using to make your predictions. So you're going to have a container that looks like this in your tray that you're going to be getting later to actually see what happens. Okay, so the standard that I was working on was the physical science standard for middle school, where they needed to show that they understood how thermal energy affects molecules and atoms and what role that would have in changing it to different states of matter. And with the activity they were doing, it showed their understanding of how the molecules would expand, how they could contract in relation to the temperature changes. All right, so for the first 3 minutes, I just want you to read through quietly, just like it says up on the screen, and then think about any kinds of questions that you might have. Okay, you're gonna be, again, working with a partner, making those predictions. So this will be your elbow partner today. So A and B, C and D. If there's three people, then again, you'll just work as a group of three. Right. In seventh grade science, virtually every day, I'm asking them to make claims about things. We visit the idea about the requirement for evidence to show that there's some reasoning involved in coming up with that claim, and then they're required to refer back to the evidence. So with the activity, what they were doing was using some of that evidence from prior activities to come up with predictions. And then as they were working in a group, they could reason out basically whether their claim was accurate even before they put it on paper, because it gave them an opportunity to talk.
So we're putting the balloon will blow up more faster.
What are you putting?
Faster.
So the balloon will.
As they were going through the activity and seeing what actually occurred, then they were given even more evidence to support the claims that they're coming up with. And they basically reasoned out from that evidence that day what they could do as a prediction for the next step. And then the next step, yet again, they're asked to make another claim where they're going to be using evidence from the activity they did, from discussions they had, from prior activities that were done as simulations, as reading, whatever it might be. And go ahead and set the container with the balloon and all the air inside back into the tray. Draw what happened. Again, model what the molecules are doing in there based on what you saw happen. So again, we've talked about this before. You've seen some simulations of what's going on, so you should have an idea what the molecules are doing. In the activity, and really with any of the activities, I want them to use the proper language or academic language, which is what it's referred to a lot as. So I kind of require them to use certain terms that I know fit with the standard that they're working on. And therefore, on the paper, there was a word bank that they had to keep referring back to and making sure that they include those terms as they show their understanding of the concept and then also show their understanding of the terms.
Okay, so molecule, we need oxygen, we need contract, and we need decrease.
Oh, but didn't we just do decrease?
And that's why I like to initially start out where they're working in groups, because that gives those that aren't really confident in their language skills a chance to talk and experience those words with students that are working on the same activity.
There's no more
hot. Yeah, because it's hot. Okay.
No, it'll stay the same.
No, it wouldn't.
It wouldn't deflate because there's not going to be no air.
The hot air makes it like go.
Yeah, go up.
Yeah. So the cold air.
It starts with nothing.
Exactly.
It's going to deflate when it starts with nothing.
It's going to stay the same.